welcome, my name is Archie and my name is Ilkan Wiersma, and today I'd like to show how I painted this Moluccan girl. And I'm trying to practice more of my portrait skills, so you will see more portraits this year of mine. And I'm also working on a project with portraits included, but I will talk to about it more later on this year. I'm just in the beginning stage, so I can and will not talk about it too much, but it will come later on. And before I start the tutorial, I'd like to share with you that I'm like painting in oils, but I couldn't find the right brands. I just didn't feel quite right, and I had one favorite, and that was the Rembrandt paint. I hope you can see it. And it's a really nice paint, it's a really nice pigment, but it still hadn't that nice feeling, that nice colors in there for me, eventually, I should say for me then. But and now I have a different brand of paint, and that is the Gemlin paint, the Gemlin. And that is a way by my favorite new paint on this moment. It's just such a beautiful, beautiful paint. And it feels a little bit buttery when you have it on your palette and on your brushes, but it paints just so, so nice, and the colors are so, so nice and so vibrant. So that's therefore now the Rembrandt is my second choice of oil paint, and the Gemlin is absolutely my favorite one to go if you would ask me what my favorite paints are. And if I don't forget, I will have some links in the video description below where you can find this paint if you like to know more about the brands. And I also try to plan on do more flowers. I normally stick with the animals. I really like painting and drawing animals, but last week I think I did a rose painting with the inktanks, and I got really great responses on that one. And also a few new subscribers, so thank you for subscribing and welcome. And I like to also try to improve on my flower drawing and painting skills. So I don't have the time to do everything, but I like to focus on the portraits and the flowers and the animals. And I have basically no time enough to paint and draw everything. But I will try to do different subjects. I like to it keeps it interest for myself. I don't like to do only portraits or only portraits of animals, and so I like to mix it up a little bit. I also like to mix with different mediums. I like the pastels, inktanks, and acrylic paints and the oil paints, and because it keeps it like I said, interest for myself. I don't like to do only one thing at a time, so therefore you see different mediums and different projects on this channel, and I hope you like that. Let's start the tutorial, and I will see you at the end of this tutorial. And also with portraits, I like to layer in my layers of color and details. And I'm saying that because every time I'm starting a new project, I have to remind myself of this fact, that I need to build up my layers. Because when I start out a painting, I'm really excited and I have this nice image in my head of how it should look in the end. But we need to also get through those ugly stages, and therefore I have to remind myself that I need to have in those layers and the texture, and just building up slowly, and eventually everything will make sense. But in this stage you can imagine that can be quite hard to image the end piece being everything into place, because it's very hard, it's very messy. But just keep calm and stay layering, and just really watch your reference photo, and you will get there in the end. But you need to practice, and you need to trust yourself and trust your layers. And that is a thing that I really, really had a hard time learning. So therefore I keep mentioning that, and hopefully I can make it a bit easier for you guys if you're watching this tutorial to start out painting and to start making your portraits. And just don't be too afraid to practice your portraits, because we all have that ugly stage, and we all need to get through that stage. So in the end it's really, really nice, and you are really proud at yourself that you did do that, because it will end up being a nice drawing of painting. But
Yeah, like I said, we have to keep that in mind to get through those layers, those ugly layers. And what I'm doing here is just building up my layers, like I said, and I'm really watching my reference photo and trying to copy some detail, but not as much. I will copy the most detail in the end of this painting, and also the teeny tiny details will come later on. I'm just really watching my lights and my darks, and also I'm not that exact with my colors. You can see here I have quite some ugly transitions between different colors. I'm using colors who are close, but not the exact colors as I will end up in my end piece. But these colors are just nice to work from. So I'm making it every time a little bit easier for me and especially for my brain to see what should go where. And that's why I'm just layering in color and building up and building up. And like I said, it's really, really important to watch your reference photo. And even though some shapes may not make sense at this time, it will make sense at the end of the painting. Therefore, just keep copying and keep trusting your reference photo. Don't try to change much while you are painting. If you think, for example, her chin would be off slightly, don't try to cover up that mistake too easy. At least it's my experience, because the shadows around the subject are also having a great influence on how it will appear in the end painting. So therefore I ended up in, especially in my beginning years of painting, making mistakes. I thought I had made mistakes and try to cover them up, and I shouldn't have, because I did need more things around the subject. For example, the chin, if I think it would be a little bit off, I'm just keep painting, and eventually I will be sure if it's off or not. But in this stage, it's really, really hard to notice when you are completely off or not. So don't try to cover up too early on. Just building up your layers. If your drawing is right, and therefore it's very, very important to start from a good drawing, you shouldn't have been that far off. So you have to trust your drawing and just keep on layering. There was a little pause there, I'm sorry. But that's very important. It's really important to start with that good drawing, and take your time to draw in your most important lines. I thought I would say details, but that's not right. I don't need that much details in my drawing before I start to paint. I just need a few basic lines where I'm working from, so I don't end up drawing in every little detail. I just need those basic lines, and to know which lines you need is also will come from experience. But there are a few lines who are very important, and for example, the lines where the eyes should go, which shapes the eyes have, and the nose and the mouth, and the shape of her head, and also the ears. Those are basically my lines which I need, and from there on I will work from with lights and darks with my paint. I just don't draw every detail in when I'm start painting, because when I started painting I thought I would need every detail drawn in, but it makes it for me it did make it much harder to notice which line and what I meant with that line. So I stopped that. I just start out using basic lines, and I thought it would be much easier to paint, for example, portraits, because it can be very distracted, for me at least, when you have a lot of pencil lines there, because you at some point you just lost a few lines and you basically don't know what you are doing. So therefore just stick and practice with basic lines. It will make it much easier for you to paint and draw portraits, if you ask me, for example, for at least. And I'm still building up, and you can see here that I have a lot more detail in here in this painting than in the beginning. It's just like I said, layer on top of layer, and with each layer I just build up my details and even more my lights and my darks. I'm not copying the colors exactly. I try to be as close as I can, and I have a tutorial on here how I mix my colors, and I think that's a very quick and easy method. So if you like that, if I don't forget, I will have a card pop up by now, so you can check that out. And it helped me really well in noticing which colors I used, and I also used that method to come up with my under layers, my under colors. I will get in the color ranges that I should be at based on my reference photo, but I'm a little bit off because I'm just building up those layers. So that's in the beginning of a drawing or painting, I will do that, and later on I'm trying to copy the colors much more even than as in the reference. But I will need layers, so if I start out with the exact colors right away, I will make it much more harder on myself to get in those nice transitions and those layers. And even though I think it may also be quite impossible, because basically layer it's the same colors over and over, and that will not look as nice as when you have quite some difference in colors and quite some different textures where needed, of course. And I had to paint over my background again because it wasn't a nice solid color. That doesn't matter, but by oils, you have to take your time, because the oils need to dry before you can apply another layer. And if those if the paint isn't quite dry yet, you will lift up some layers when you're applying a new layer, and that will look very weird, and it's hard to cover up those spaces where you lift up some paint. So keep that in mind, keep your time when you are painting in oils, and I mean by that, let it dry when needed. Don't paint too much along, and because you will end up with a muddy colors, or you will lift up on layers underneath the layer you are applying. So, and here is the photo of the painting, and it's finished now. This is how it looks in daylight, at least the closest. And I'm really proud of this portrait. It was I was quite excited to paint this one, because I really like her face. I really like her eyes and her expression, and also her clothes. I really like that color, that reddish color. And I'm happy how it came out.
So I hope you like this tutorial. And before we end this this one, I'd like to mention that I really like to use the Gamfar varnish. And I have that one, I have a comparison between the gloss varnish and the satin varnish on my channel. I will have a card pop up by now, so you can check that out. And I really like the gloss varnish, because because it brings up the vibrant inner colors even more than it already did of the oil paint itself. The Gamelin has really rich colors, but when you apply the Gamfar gloss varnish, it's really much vibrant than it already was. So therefore I like to mention that I'm really happy with that varnish, and I use it all the time with my oil paintings. So therefore maybe you want to check that comparison out, and you can see it on yourself how I do that and how the difference it will make on your paintings. So that said and done, if you like, you can follow me on Instagram, on Facebook, and my own website. And if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. And if you like this tutorial and other tutorials and you didn't already have, please subscribe in this corner, I think, on my channel. And I hope to see you at one of my next videos. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.